This is CNN, the most trusted name in news.
Happening now, breaking news, more Russians revealed. We now know 8 people possibly were inside that controversial meeting with Donald Trump Jr. and a Russian lawyer, more than we originally were told by the Trump team. This hour, new details about a Russian lobbyist's role and documents possibly brought to the secret meeting. Transparent. President Trump has praised his son for going public with incriminating emails about the Russia meeting. But tonight, new fuel for concerns that Trump Jr. still isn't telling all. And welcome our viewers here in the United States and around the world. Wolf Blitzer is off. I'm Jim Acosta. You're in the Situation Room.
This is CNN Breaking News.
Breaking news tonight, new evidence that the Trump team hasn't fully come clean about a 2016 meeting with a Russian lawyer that's fueled more questions about possible collusion. CNN has learned that 8 possible people were inside that meeting, more than Donald Trump Jr. spoke about publicly. According to multiple reports, a Russian-American lobbyist with alleged ties to Kremlin intelligence says he was in the meeting that included the president's son, his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, and former Trump campaign chairman, Paul Manafort. The lobbyist reportedly says the Russian lawyer brought documents related to the Democratic National Committee. These new revelations are only adding to the suspicion surrounding the meeting in the midst of the presidential campaign. It was arranged with a promise that the Trump camp would get dirt on Hillary Clinton from Moscow, information Trump Jr. says he never got. The top Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee calls the new details deeply disturbing. Tonight, top Trump White House aides are at risk of being dragged into the special counsel investigation for their roles in crafting the administration's incomplete and changing explanation of the meeting. This hour, I'll get reaction from a Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee. Congressman Denny Heck, our correspondents and specialists, are also standing by. First, to CNN's Diane Gallagher with more on the players in that pivotal Russia meeting. Diane, I spoke with a White House official who admitted earlier today it's not a good thing that the Trump world story keeps changing.
Jim, another day, another version of the story, it seems, and now another player with ties to Russia is revealed to have attended this meeting. So while Donald Trump Jr. said that he released the emails to the public in the name of transparency, tonight it seems he did not divulge everything.
Tonight, this man, a Russian-American lobbyist who one senator has accused of being in Soviet counterintelligence, has been thrust into the center of the Russia investigation. Rinat Akhmetshin now tells the Associated Press and other outlets he, too, was in the controversial meeting with the president's son at Trump Tower in June of 2016. Until now, Donald Trump Jr. had said the only people in the meeting were the Russian attorney, Natalia Veselnitskaya, the president's son-in-law and presidential advisor, Jared Kushner, and former Trump campaign chairman, Paul Manafort.
So as far as you know, as far as this incident is concerned, this is all of it.
This is everything. This is everything.
But tonight, CNN has learned as many as 8 people were in the room, including Akhmetshin, a translator, a representative of the Russian family that initiated the meeting, and Rob Goldstone, the music publicist who set it all up. In one of the emails released by Don Jr., Goldstone writes to him, quote, "I will send the names of the 2 people meeting with you for security when I have them later today." No names were included in the released emails, in which Goldstone promised, quote, some official documents and information that would incriminate Hillary in her dealings with Russia and would be very useful to your father. Akhmetshin is a Russian-American registered lobbyist for Veselnitskaya's organization, focused on overturning an American law that sanctions human rights abusers in Russia, according to lobbying records. In an April letter to Homeland Security Secretary John Kelly, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley described Akhmetshin as a Russian immigrant who has, quote, been accused of acting as an unregistered agent for Russian interest and apparently has ties to Russian intelligence. Akhmetshin denied any of those ties to the Washington Post, saying, I never worked for the Russian government. I served as a soldier for 2 years. At no time have I ever worked for Russian government or any of its agencies. I was not an intelligence officer. Never. The new disclosure represents yet another version of who was in the room and adds to a growing list of questions about why the story keeps changing. Sources close to Kushner's legal team tell CNN his lawyers and White House aides started coming up with a strategy about how to manage the disclosures of the emails back in late June. Kushner amended his security clearance to include the Trump Tower meeting after his team discovered the emails preparing for his congressional testimony. President Trump maintains he did not know about the meeting until just before his son released the emails and continues to defend him.
As far as my son is concerned, my son is a wonderful young man. I think from a practical standpoint, Most people would have taken that meeting.
But a White House official tells CNN that top advisors know it's not good that the story keeps changing.
And now Nancy Pelosi has joined the chorus of Democrats calling for Jared Kushner's security clearance to be revoked. Also, the scramble to respond to that slow drip of detail coming out may have actually exposed some White House aides to special counsel scrutiny. Robert Mueller's team could call them to explain what they know about the meeting. Jim?
The investigation is expanding. Diane Gallagher, thank you very much. Now let's take a closer look at the Russian-American lobbyist who reportedly was in that meeting with Donald Trump Jr. and others. Our chief national security correspondent, Jim Sciutto, is digging on that. Jim, what are we learning?
Well, this is the second Russian figure that we've had to sort of familiarize ourselves with this week. First, it was the Russian lawyer who was the impetus, really, for this meeting, powerful lobbyist, etc. But now you have another powerful lobbyist with questions, at least, about his past, including ties to the Kremlin, but also a past in the military, and the question, the possibility of ties to Russian intelligence as well.
The June 2016 meeting at Trump Tower with Donald Trump Jr., Jared Kushner, and Paul Manafort included more people beyond the Russian lawyer Natalia Veselnitskaya, a source familiar with the circumstances, tells CNN. Russian-American lobbyist Renat Akhmetshin told several media outlets that he was also in the meeting. Akhmetshin told reporters for the New York Times and Washington Post that he's a veteran of the Soviet Army. In a March letter to the Justice Department, Senate Judiciary Chairman Chuck Grassley described Akhmetshin as, quote, someone with ties to Russian intelligence, someone alleged to have conducted political disinformation campaigns as part of a pro-Russia lobbying effort.
Plainly, this Russian attorney, this other third party, if they were present, they were there to both deliver a message as well as to receive a message. And plainly, Moscow understood only too well that this is conduct that the Trump campaign would really appreciate.
Akhmetshin denied any intelligence links to the Washington Post, saying, quote, at no time have I ever worked for the Russian government or any of its agencies. I was not an intelligence officer, never. He also told the Post he was born in Russia and became a U.S. citizen in 2009. Akhmetshin's lobbying effort, which he did on behalf of the Russian lawyer Veselnitskaya, was aimed at repealing the Magnitsky Act, which sanctions Russians accused of human rights abuses. A complaint filed against him with the Department of Justice claims that effort was on behalf of the Kremlin.
I spoke earlier today to GOP Congressman Adam Kinzinger, and he made a point to me, Jim, that many intelligence officials have made as well, that when Russia is doing intelligence operations, they don't necessarily deploy people in uniforms, right, with KGB name tags, etc. In fact, they don't do that. They use what are called cutouts. They use people who are tied to the Kremlin, former military officers, lobbyists, etc. You know, that doesn't establish that that's exactly what this meeting was, but it fits a pattern. And that's something that both Democrats and Republicans on the investigated committees have said is important to note. It would not have to be obvious to still fall under the category of, or at least an attempt at a Russian intelligence operation. And that's a key line of inquiry as they continue to look into this meeting and other meetings.
It's amazing that 1 week ago, Vladimir Putin was denying to President Trump that Russia meddled in the election. Jim Sciutto.